Hare Krishna, dear friends, dear Vaishnavas. Around 5,200 years ago, at the end of the last Dwapar Yug, Sri Krishna appeared as the son of Vasudeva and Devaki in the holy place of Mathura. The appearance of the Lord Janmashtami did not just take place only once, long, long ago in ancient India. It takes place again and again at all times across the universe. Out of these constant recurring appearances, the most wonderful is when Lord Krishna makes his appearance within the heart. But how does God appear so personally for us? The answer is in the Priti Sandarbha. Bhakti brings one to the Lord. Bhakti reveals the Lord, and bhakti brings the Lord under control. Bhakti is stronger than the Supreme Personality of Godhead himself. Thus, we pray for bhakti, or devotion to Krishna, to manifest in the heart. Without bhakti, Krishna might stand right in front of your eyes, but you won't see him. So in order to bind Krishna, we need bhakti. But how do we get it? Narada Muni shares the answer. Number one, worship the Lord. Engage the mind and senses in spiritual activities. Number two, give up selfish sense gratification and association with those attracted to material life as much as possible. And three, hear and chant about the Supreme Lord's name and qualities, even when you're engaged in day-to-day life. Finally, Narad Muni concludes, primarily, one develops bhakti by the mercy of great souls, or by a small drop of Krishna's mercy. So we can try our best to execute worship of the Lord, give up sense gratification, and to hear and chant the Lord's glories. But don't forget, my dear friends, it's not about mechanical practices, but the gifts of grace that primarily can bring bhakti to our hearts. Hare Krishna.